What is going on, guys? In this video, I want to show you a cool little demo that I've been working on for the NaNEye app. Please join the goddamn Discord. Love you guys. All right. So basically, you know, I've been trying to lose weight. I use chronometer, weigh things daily. Wanted to make things simpler, basically track with using vision language models. And so first I used that just to track the actual calories. But then we didn't get the actual micronutrients, and I want that. So I added like a database of food items where we have complete nutritional information, and then we can do more hardcore stuff. So basically, if I do something like I ate 200 grams of cottage cheese and 80 grams of tuna, because I actually just ate that, it's actually pretty good, you know? Like, it's simple, good macros. Cheap, fast, can't ask for more, you know? So let's see, it's thinking. All right, so cottage cheese, it matched it in the database to cottage cheese. This is good. When it's matched, that means that we have complete complete micronutrient profile of the item. Same for tuna. Now, where I haven't come to, like, look, if you eat whatever it's called, like skipjack tuna, or if you eat like albacore tuna, it'll have like slightly different micronutrients. Like the omega-3s are actually like two times as much in albacore, but hey, we haven't gotten to that point yet. Anyways, yeah, that sounds good. It said it as snacks. You know, you can tell it like it should be under something else. All right, and then if we go to the diet tab, basically we'll have that now. It just stored it. And let's say we have like an image instead. Let's say we had some McDonald's, you know, hey, analyze my meal. I am very healthy. And it'll take a little bit. Still working on the time, like the time sync delay. I don't know what to expect. It takes maybe like 15 seconds. Anyways, so burger, no database match found. Maybe I should add that, probably. I'll expand it over time, you know. French fries, we can see like it's not a perfect match because it matches to frozen. Maybe the grams will be different. You can tell it, you know, like don't do that or change the grams or something. And here, no database match found. Like we can ask it, how many calories did you estimate for the burger and the Coca-Cola? So for the burger, the estimated for the cola, the estimated calories are 200. Let's say it should be Coca-Cola zero, Coca-Cola zero. Cool. All right. So again, no database match found, but it changed the calories. Maybe I'll change so that we also get, I'll change that so that we get basically the calories and the macros here as well. So you get like a general sense. Yeah, I think that's honestly better for the UI, like seeing the macros. But anyways, yeah, that sounds good. Store it. And now, basically, when it's no database match found, we won't get the actual micronutrients. We could have obviously told it, you know, break down the burger to the actual, you know, the components of the burger. And similarly, actually, that's the only thing we could have done here. But I think it makes sense to have like a general burger kind of in the database. So I'll work on adding more items as we go along. But anyways, now if we go to diet, basically we'll have those calories as well. Now, what's going to be cool, guys, is I don't show it in the UI yet, but in the actual database, we have all the micronutrients for these things. If it was in the database, which means that we can get like very detailed analytics on what we're eating. And not only that, right? Because we have, I'm storing the HRV values, resting heart rates, sleep, all this stuff, right? We can start to answer questions like, what's the optimal diet for you? Because we can look at the actual values and we can start to do correlation and even possibly causation analysis on what in your diet causes your recovery to improve or not, right? So basically, as I've been, basically we will start, and this is the next step of the app, is to put these things together so that we can actually start to see and give recommendations and insights as to what you should do more and less of, right? So I actually just want to show you like one thing that I found pretty interesting, okay? This is from October. I was not healthy at this point. I'm still not that healthy, but you know, like here it was pretty stable, right? Here is when I started tracking stuff, right? So you can see instantly that it went up. It went down a little bit, but it went up a lot during June, like a lot. And one thing that I realized is that I've been losing like 10 pounds or 5 kilograms about since this time, okay? So what, like if it was the weight, then why did it go down later on? And then when I looked at my logs or my journal, where I track like what I'm doing and stuff, let's see. Then I actually noticed that during the entire of June, I took omega-3 supplements. And I believe that that's what caused a very great spike in the HRV. I don't know, but maybe. Either way, with these additions in the app, I'm very soon going to be able to find out what should I be eating and what should I not be eating? What are the optimal macronutrient distribution for me? How many grams of omega-3 should I eat? How many grams of zinc, magnesium, potassium, vitamin A, vitamin K, vitamin E? All of that, right? So I'm very excited for that. Yeah, that's it. Thank you for watching this video. Join the Discord. Join in on the beta. The app is a work in progress, but it's improving. All right, see you guys.